Chapter 32, The Strategy of Open City Gates. One who excels at war does not appear formidable. One who excels in defeating the enemy does not join issue. This is known as the virtue of non-contention. From Lao Tzu, the Tao Te Ching. When the enemy is superior in numbers and your situation is such that you expect to be overrun at any moment, then drop all pretense of military preparedness and act casually. Unless the enemy has an accurate description of your situation, this unusual behavior will arouse suspicions. With luck, he will be dissuaded from attacking. From the Three Kingdoms period, China. In 149 BC, the famous strategist Kong Ming of Shu, wishing to attack the state of Wei, sent an advance force to scout for the enemy. Leading the army of Wei was Sima Yi, who also sent an advance force of 50,000 troops. The two vanguards met and engaged in battle, but the Wei forces were superior and won the day. The defeated Shu vanguard raced back to the main body of Kong Ming's army, whose troops, seeing the look of fear in the faces of their comrades, thought that the enemy was upon them and fled in panic. Kong Ming and a few bodyguards fled to the city of Yangping with the Wei army in hot pursuit. Vastly outnumbered and unable to either retreat or sustain a siege, Kong Ming played a last resort strategy that made him famous throughout China. He removed all the guards and battle flags from the walls and had all four of the city gates flung open. When Sima Yi approached the city, he could see only a few old men nonchalantly sweeping the grounds within the gates. Kong Ming was seen sitting in one of the towers, smiling and playing his lute. Sima Yi remarked to his advisers, "That man seems to be too happy for my comfort. Doubtless he has some deep-laid scheme in mind to bring us all to disaster." As they stood spellbound, the strains of Kong Ming's lute reached their ears, and this only heightened their sense of foreboding. Such peculiar behavior was too suspicious. Fearing a clever trap, Sima Yi turned his army back and retreated. After the army left, Kong Ming and his remaining troops departed in the opposite direction and made their way safely back to their capital. Summary. In a desperate situation, often the only recourse is to do something completely unexpected. Unusual behavior in a time of crisis arouses suspicions and doubts. Placing doubt in your enemy's mind means he is already half defeated. However, this strategy requires supreme self-control. Those nervous about the chances for failure will, by their actions, give away the bluff.